mom would take the chair, put it on the driveway. And Ryan would run around the house. And it was great fun. And he would just run around the house, and run around the house, and run around the house. And it was so fun to watch, because he got the greatest joy out of running around the house. Then we went to go see a show with Spot about, at that point it was called Christian New Theater. And it was Willy Wonka. And I'm like, oh, that's the kid that lives across the street. That's the kid that lives across the street, because I didn't know his name. And he was playing Augustus Gloop. And it was one of my favorite roles I've ever seen him in. And so intermission, we go in and I ran into his mom in the bathroom. I said, hey, you live across the street from me. I'd love to work with your son. And so I've been working with this kid since he was in sixth grade. End of sixth grade, about that point. And again, he was shorter than me. And could sing as high as me at that point. So we've been through many shows together. He just does one show after another. I think you did a total of how many in Spotlight? 28 shows with a group called Spotlight. From small roles up to leading roles. Some of my favorite roles is Dustus Gloop. He was also, Mr. Oliver Warbucks in Annie. And that was one of his first leading roles. And we drove a long way to go see it, and it was worth it. Played Schroeder in You're a Good Man and Charlie Brown, which I missed, but it was great fun getting ready for that one. In Seussical, he was Max Gall. And the reason I like that one so much as well, because Toby was in that show, and they were in a show together, and I thought that was pretty cool. And then most recently, he did Legally Blonde, which unfortunately I was not able to see, because I had recitals or something like that going on. The year before, he played in, come on, your curtains, Oscar Shapiro, and that was an amazing show. I enjoyed that one. That's his resume. He's headed off to Columbia College next year in Chicago. Which we knew in sixth grade that he would be majoring in music theater. Along the way, he said he was going to major in other things, but I always knew music theater. I could not be more proud of this guy. Come a long way singing soprano, through the cracking of the voice, through the dropping of the voice, through going through what you do when you are a teenager. And getting through all the trials and everything you have is this, when you work one-on-one with a student for 7 years, you get to know them. And you do more than train them musically. We have philosophical discussions sometimes. Dare I say we sometimes talk politics?
That's not safe for people.
And, yeah. And it's enlightening to hear the viewpoint of someone young and growing and coming into his own. And we are going to see amazing things from this kid on stage, and personally, I think he's going to be an award-winning director. That's where I think he's headed. So, again, I could not be more proud of you. I have something for you.
And my awful handwriting. I passed a change to the third grade.
Yes,